Man bobsled competition. The crowd is making its way to the top of the hill. There's only one way to the peak. It used to be an old logging trail. They come by taxi, they come by bus, they walk and they take the gondola. John and I decided to take the gondola to work today. And you know, we talked so much about the two-man bobsled competition earlier in the week and the advantage that the Soviets and East Germans had with their aerodynamically designed sleds. Is there that big of an advantage in the four-man bobs?
Well, not as much because you got so much more weight. The four-man's weigh 1,387 pounds as compared to 846 pounds. And in the two-man bobs, it's like a sports car. You can put the sled on almost any place you want. You get in out of trouble quickly. Four-man's not like that. The four-man goes where it wants to go. We compare the two-man to the sports car. The four-man's a big luxury vehicle. So that's not as much of an advantage with the Soviet shark sled and the East German suspension here as they had the two-man.
There are 24 competitors at the top of Mount Trebevich waiting for the final run. Keep in mind, the final time is a combined total of four separate heats. The standings, East Germany number one with Wolfgang Hoppe in first place. Number two is Bernhard Lehmann of East Germany, and the Swiss, Silvio Giobellina, in third. Wolfgang Hoppe, the East German who wasn't even sent to the European Championships here at Trebevich last winter, continues his assault for the Sarajevo gold, knowing that he's pretty well locked up a medal. Now he wants the top prize. Wolfgang Hoppe, big, strong 26-year-old. Roland Vetsik is number two man. He, too, is a discus champion. Dietmar Schauerhammer belongs to the motor club in Jena, 6'2", 200 pounds, and Andreas Kirschner, the brakeman, 6'3", 220 pounds. John, they are all good-sized athletes.
Good size, big, fast, well-conditioned, and part of the sports military operation that East Germany runs for other athletes. Their start times speak for themselves.
Hoppe came out of nowhere. You have to wonder how many other Wolfgang Hoppes there are in the program in East Germany.
I consider him the second generation East Germany. The Lehmann is part of that first generation of East German riders and drivers that started in 76. And I agree with you. There's probably two or three more Hoppes that they're just grooming back there.
Wolfgang Hoppe, his army job involves building heavy machinery. And he loves working with this machine.
Start time on the left is the Italian two sled, 6:32. That's just like his first heat.
Again, an outstanding start for Wolfgang Hoppe. His assault on the goal as he comes down. The last trip on this frosty road at Mount Trebevich.
He had four great runs in the two-man. He did three great runs in the four-man with no mistake. That's like somebody in baseball going up there being 7-for-7.
He has been the king of the hill all week. Now he's just trying to alleviate any mistakes.
Comes out of the, watch his foot time on the left, 32.45
as he comes down the Omega. He'll shoot out of that, go through two, turn nine, and all they have left is the Labyrinth.
He's got a better heat going than his first heat here. What consistency this East German, unbelievable.
Shoots through the Labyrinth. The final whip through and down with a time of 50.21. Again, it solidifies his first place standing.
His last three heats have been 50-18, 50-18, 50-21. That's consistency.
Now, Wolfgang Hoppe, East Germany 1, just has to hold on to win the gold.
Syrian bobsledding is the fastest distance between two points is a straight low line. Watch this East German sled driven by Hoppe. Up high now, but watch him dive out lower than anybody else's marks. And that's why the East Germans are leading these competitions.
This is Bernhard Lehmann of East Germany, 0.033 of a second out of first place. Tremendous competition between he and his countryman, Wolfgang Hoppe. Won the gold in 76, he won a silver here last week. The second man behind Bernhard Lehmann is Bogdan Musial, a sprinter. The third position, Ingo Foga, 26 years old, rather small, 175 pounds. And Eberhard Weiss is the brakeman, a motor mechanic from Oberhof. As you look at the East Germans working on their sled, scientific, aerodynamic in its design, you have to wonder how the sport got its name bobsledding. In 1924, at the first Winter Games in Chamonix, France, there was no running push. The sledders gained momentum by bobbing back and forth. Look at them here, following the command of the driver who orchestrated the start. Bobsledding, much more sophisticated now, but the name of the sport remains with its origin. John, you have to wonder now, the sled like this, we've seen several of them of this style get into some trouble in the ruts. What about the steering? Do they ever lose control of the ropes?
Well, the ropes in the guy's hands, actually, if they get into a rut, the ropes can be ripped right out of your hands, which is a very, very dangerous maneuver in bobsledding. But this track is totally cut up. It's very, very possible. Lehmann has not had a good heat the last time out.
This is his last trip. He knows what he has to do. He trails the leader by 0.033 of a second. His push time, very competitive, but a little bit off the pace.
6:42, that's unlike Lehmann. Again, we talked about his countryman being 7-for-7. He's 8-for-8 with eight great heats. He hit there again. Lehmann was 5-for-7. The last two times on the mountain, he has not been an East German pilot.
His sled sliding a little bit across the ice, which loses time.
Well, tell you, if he's a bad heat here, the Swiss could catch up to him. Silvio Giovellini and Vassar both have yet to come. Let's watch for split time. 32.6, 2200. That's a lot of time. He's in a skid there. This is not a good heat for Lehman.
He has to have a tremendous run through the labyrinth and the finish curve. We'll see what he does.
Oh, and he's late there, too. This is not Lehman, but the pressure must be getting to him.
Bernhard Lehman coming around the final curve. The time on the left, the time he needs to beat. 50-44 puts him in second place. But will that hold up against the Swiss?
Well, I tell you, that's just the way when Silvio Giovellini had last time. Giovellini had a bad heat. So Lehman knows it. Look, he knows he didn't have a good heat.
3:20.78, the aggregate time of Bernhard Lehman. So with Silvio Giovellini of Switzerland yet to come, the standings look like this. East Germany number one, holding on to first place, followed closely by East Germany number two and the Soviets number one sled. This is one of the prettiest, best-designed sleds on the hill. Switzerland number two, the driver's Eckhard Fosser. He's called the man without nerves. His number two man is Hans Merkey, ex-sprinter, 5'11", 185 pounds. Kurt Poletti's number three, former speed skater, former sprinter, and the brakeman, Rolf Strittmatter, former 400-meter sprint champion from Zurich.
Fosser has to come down this hill in a super time. He's had a lot of problems the last heat.
He was in fourth place after the last heat. He knows what's in front of him. He knows that he's got a shot at a medal. The time that you're going to see on the left belongs to Zinta Sikmanis, the best push time of the day, 6:30. His push time, 6:51. Still off the pace. He can't be happy with that.
I can't believe the Swiss push times. I've never seen the Swiss be so non-competitive at the start in the history of watching bobsledding for me.
What's causing it?
I don't know what to say. The Swiss just aren't competitive at the start. Again, I've never seen that, Timmy.
Eckhard Fosser trying to get up the top three, trying to win a medal, currently in fourth place.
It's very smooth in the corners, 5 and 6 out of 7. Let's watch for a split time. 2:45 is the East German on the left. 50 hundredths off the East German. It's not a good heat for Fosser.
Did a little loop in Omega as he comes down through curve 9. He'll head into the labyrinth.
He's smooth there in the first labyrinth, the second labyrinth, the third labyrinth. He's smooth down here, but again, I don't think it's a good time for Fosser.
Time on the left is what he needs. The time he has, through and down, 51.03, currently in third place. But I don't think that's going to hold up.
Not a competitive time for Eckhard Fosser. This guy was the world champion last year. I don't think it's the same guy.
Aggregate time, 3:22.90 for Eckhard Fosser. Silvio Giovellini of Switzerland still to come.